So today I'm going to make this fettuccine with creamy tomato sausage sauce or something. This is a recipe that my Italian grandmother used to make, and I think you'll like it a lot. The first thing I'm going to do is coarsely chop 3 large shallots and dice 2 large cloves of garlic. Actually, my grandmother wasn't Italian. I just wanted to say that. And she never made this recipe. I found it on the web. Okay, she wasn't even my grandmother. She was my grandfather's mistress. Same thing. Okay, let's peel all of this. Oh boy, that's getting my eyes. They say if you peel onions underwater, you don't get the tearing effect. But I tried that once and I almost drowned by the time I got the onion peeled. Okay, that's done. Now I need about 1/2 pound of hot Italian sausage. And I bought this that comes in the casing, and remove the casing. And I would say that's just about 1/2 pound. That is just slightly over. That's good. That's fine. And I also need 1/2 pound of sweet Italian sausage. And this is a little over 1 pound. This is loose. So I'm just going to use about 1/2 of that. And we'll break that up. I'll save that for something else. Okay, now I need a couple tablespoons of olive oil, 1, 2, I'll heat that up, take my funky old brush and brush it around. Okay, I'm adding the shallots and the garlic, and saute those until the onions are translucent. They don't have to be too soft. Yeah, I just added a generous amount of salt to the fettuccine water. Never add oil to your pasta water. Really does not keep things from sticking, and what it does, the pasta absorbs the oil, so it doesn't absorb the sauce that you're making so well. Now I'm going to add the sausage, break it up. This until the meat is no longer pink. That looks pretty good. Now I'm going to add 2 cans of diced tomatoes with the juice. And 1 tablespoon of rubbed sage. And now I'm going to add 1 cup of heavy cream, that's whipping cream. And bring that up to a simmer and let it simmer for about 5 minutes, stirring it frequently. And I'll add some of that pasta water if I need to. Need to add a little salt. If I want to add pepper, since we're using hot sausage, but yeah, why not? I just won't do much. This is a little like an andouille sauce, but not quite. Okay, I've drained the fettuccine, reserving a half a cup of the pasta water, and I'm putting the fettuccine back into its original pan, and I'm going to add the sauce to that. And just for the heck of it, I'm going to add some of this pasta water. Might help thicken it up a little bit. This is another reason why you want to make sure that the fettuccine is just barely al dente, because it's going to continue cooking in this liquid and absorbing the sauce. And there you have it, topped with a little good quality Parmesan cheese. Let's taste it. See how good it is. It's delicious. It's really, really good.